Hallelujah. I want to begin from Jordan, because that is where the topic of today is. Praise the Lord. I'm talking about the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit is Jordan. Praise the Lord. The first baptism that took place to the children of Israel was in the Red Sea. When they passed through the Red Sea, there was the baptism of the water, the immersion. Praise the Lord. So when Moses was just about to cross, that's why God did not allow the Israelites to go through the shorter way and made them to go through the Red Sea so that they could be baptized. Praise the name of Jesus. They walked and walked and walked, and Moses did his part. We heard when the man of God was saying in the morning that Moses represents the law. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. Meaning Joshua represents grace. So when Joshua comes and God tells Joshua that now my servant Moses is dead and you have to pick up from where he has left. Praise the Lord. He did not change his words. He told Joshua that as I was with Moses, I will be with you. Amen. Hallelujah. And now God comes with a pattern when they are just about to cross Jordan. And God says that choose 12 people from every tribe of Israel that they may pick 12 stones. Praise the Lord. And number 12 is the government of Jesus. So God introduces Jesus into the equation. Praise the name of Jesus. So when Jesus comes and the tribes of Israel, they are 12, and the government of Jesus is represented by the priesthood, and we know Jesus is the priest, high priest in the order of Melchizedek. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. And the first time Melchizedek appears, or the one priest appears in the Bible, was when Abraham was just about to fight the enemies. Praise the Lord. Amen. And we see that after meeting Melchizedek, he won the battle. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. So when the Spirit of God is speaking to us that we have crossed, somebody say, I've crossed. I have crossed. Hallelujah. Amen. No matter what happens now, you have crossed. Amen. Because the priest stood in the middle of Jordan, and the Jordan stood still. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. And they passed in Jordan as if it was a road. So we have crossed. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. So we find that Jordan, when they cross Jordan, they are given the symbol of Jesus, meaning grace entered at that time. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. So we find even the priests and the servants of God, the prophets, coming after Joshua, they operated in grace. Hallelujah. Amen. So our topic today is the Holy Spirit. And when that word dropped, I said, God. So this Jordan is the Holy Ghost, because it is the second baptism. John baptized Jesus and said, at the baptism of Jesus, the Bible says that, and the Spirit of the Lord descended upon Jesus and in the form of a dove. So for sure, when you cross Jordan, you are filled by the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We are going to read from the book of Acts of the Apostles, and we are going to look through the Bible from Genesis through to Revelation. When we are talking about the Holy Ghost, the key scripture I'll be talking about is Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, verses 8. Allow me to read it from King James Version, from verse 1. Acts of the Apostles, you can check your Bible. I know we have different versions. We are told, Acts of Apostles chapter 1. I'll read from verse 1. The former treatise have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach until the day in which he was taken up, after that he through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking in the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. Verse 4. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but said he, wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, will thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father has put in his own power, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, in Samaria, and unto the outermost parts of the world. And verse 9, and when he had spoken these things, while they beheld, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. Father, in Jesus' name, you are bread, you are provided for us. Break it that we may consume it. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Jordan has introduced us to the Holy Spirit. And here we are. Jesus is speaking to his disciples after his ascension, after his resurrection. The book of Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1, is written by Luke. Luke is continuing to write. Praise the Lord Jesus. We find him writing in the first chapter of Luke to Theophilus. And he's still addressing Theophilus in the book of Acts. Meaning he's telling out what happened during the arrest of Jesus, the crucifixion, and the resurrection. And still, he is in the spirit trying to tell us what happened after the ascension of the Christ. Praise the Lord Jesus. The Holy Spirit, one, is given unto us as the church. The first time Jesus mentions the church, or the word church is written in the Bible, is in Matthew chapter 16, verses 17. When Jesus is talking to the disciples, and he asks the disciples, what do people say I am? Praise the name of Jesus. And he says, some say you are Elijah. Some say you are Isaiah. Some say you are the sons of other prophets. But Jesus goes further and asks, and you, whom do you think I am? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And Jesus, Peter replies and says, that you are the Christ, the Son of God. And what amuses me is what Jesus, the response of Jesus. Jesus tells Peter that flesh and blood has not revealed this unto you. Meaning, there is a revelation of flesh and blood. Praise the name of Jesus. And in the church today, most of the body of Christ walks in the revelation of the flesh and blood, living the revelation of the Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. Jesus introduces something new to us in verses 18. He tells the disciples that upon this revelation, upon the revelation of the Holy Ghost that Peter has revealed Jesus as the Christ, he will build his church, and no gates of hell shall prevail against it. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning, with the Holy Ghost, no gates of hell can prevail against us. So, Jesus introduces to us the person of the Spirit. Hallelujah. So, when Peter has given his answer, and Jesus has given his response to the answer of Peter, we find later in the gospel books where Jesus did not call Tim, did not call Joe, praise the Lord. He did not call Andrew, but he said, Peter, do you love me? Why was he talking to Peter? Because the Spirit of God revealed to Peter who Jesus was, and Peter could carry the foundation of the church. Praise the name of Jesus. So the Holy Spirit is the foundation of the church. Before the church, there were temples. They could go to the temples. You would hear that there is this Spirit upon. The Spirit could come upon and go. The hand of the Lord would hear his mantling someone, and then that person could do something, and then it goes. Praise the Lord Jesus. So the Spirit of the Lord is the hand of the Lord that could mantle someone. In the old days, when the Spirit of the Lord had not manifested to be with us. Praise the name of the Lord. And we find that before the coming of the Holy Ghost, those people were not born again. They were just there. Even Peter, before Jesus went, he was not born again. Praise the name of Jesus. They walked with Jesus, but they were not born again. Why? Because Jesus had not died. Paul tells us in Romans that if you have to believe, you must believe that Jesus died and he was resurrected. So after the resurrection of Jesus, that is when salvation came. Hallelujah. With salvation came the Holy Ghost. And that is why after the resurrection of Jesus, he took 40 days teaching the disciples, because they were not ready to carry the Holy Ghost. They were not ready to walk with the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of Jesus. So they had to be taken through some teachings. 1, 2, 3, you have to know this. So after that, Jesus told them, when they asked Jesus is going and he's asking them, they are asking Jesus, that will you restore the kingdom to Israel? And then he tells them, it is not in your times to know. Praise the name of Jesus. It is not in you to know when Jesus is coming back. The times when the Father has put, it is in his seasons. But, praise the name of the Lord, he changes the story. Meaning we must know. He says you should not know. But, he says in verse 8, you shall receive the power. The power there in Greek means dunamis. And dunamis means power to, you have ability to effect changes. Praise the name of Jesus. You shall receive the power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And with the power that you have received, you shall be witnesses unto me. Praise the name of Jesus. So it is expedient for a Christian, a child of God, to receive the power of the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. By us believing that Jesus is Lord gives us a measure of faith. Praise the name of the Lord. But the word of God says in Romans chapter 1 verse 17 that we move from faith to faith. Meaning the infilling of the Holy Ghost can also be from level to level. We see it in the book of Ezekiel chapter 47. Praise the name of Jesus. When the water is measured 1,000 cubits. So when Jesus went, it means the disciples were filled, but they were not fully filled. Praise the name of the Lord. So there's a place where as a child of God, you need to wait. You need to tarry. Praise the name of Jesus. That you may be filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And I want to declare to us that today is another day that we're going to be filled into another level. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. If you are a worshiper, I don't know why God is speaking a voice through the worshipers, that there is a new grace of worship that is coming up. Praise the name of Jesus. That you need an infilling. Hallelujah. Now, the Holy Ghost is a comforter. When we look at the book of John chapter 14, verse 16, Jesus gives us an assurance. I will paraphrase. That I will give you a comforter. Greek says, analos parakletos. Analos parakletos means another one of the same kind. Meaning, if Jesus remained here, then the Holy Ghost would have not come. Praise the name of the Lord. And then we would be limited. Praise the name of Jesus. Jesus died that he may bring many sons to glory. He is the first begotten son. But there are other begotten sons. Hallelujah. Which are you and I. So, we have to be filled with the comforter, who is Jesus in us. I love the way Paul tells the church of Philippians, that Christ in me, the hope of all glory. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning, in the inside of you, you have the Christ, you have the Holy Ghost, you are here with Christ in God. Praise the name of Jesus. So Jesus himself had to go for the Holy Spirit to come. Praise the name of Jesus. When you look at the book of Genesis, chapter 1, the Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. The earth was formless and void. Darkness over the surface of the deep. And the Spirit of God. If you read Amplified Version, says, and the Spirit of God brooded upon the waters. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning the Holy Ghost has the capability to brood. And something which has been bred must be hatched. Praise the name of Jesus. Today is your day of hatching new levels in the name of Jesus. So when the Spirit of God brooded, the Bible says in verse 3, there was darkness, verse 1. Chaos. The earth was chaotic. Your life was mixed up. And when the Spirit brooded, the Bible says in verse 3, and God said light. Message Version says, God said light. He didn't say let there be. He said light. And light appeared. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So when God said light, and light appeared, the Spirit of God was the light. So when we receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, then we have the light. That's why Jesus says, you are the light of the world. A city set on the hill. Matthew chapter 5 verse 14. You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill. So, let your light shine before men. Praise the name of Jesus. So, the church today has to walk filled by the Holy Spirit. Indwelling, not coming upon. Praise the name of the Lord. The Holy Spirit is, we have God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So it is in the triune nature of God, the third persona of God, that is the Holy Spirit, who is the third persona of God. And when Jesus comes, he is the representation of Jesus, when the Holy Ghost is here with us. Praise the name of Jesus. During creation, God, in Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, we find God as a committee. And God says, let us. Who are these us who are with God? It is God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. He says, let us create man in our own image and after our likeness. So, the Holy Spirit is the creator. I'm going to go through the definition of that Holy Spirit, the way I've gone through it. I want us to understand, because we are going to receive an infilling of the Holy Ghost, and we are going to get to the depth of who this Holy Ghost is, what he can do, because the Holy Spirit is a person. Praise the name of Jesus. We call him it. The Holy Spirit is a person. It is represented by he is a person. So as we are going deeper, we want to know how the Holy Ghost can get into us. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We have seen in the book of John chapter 14 verse 16, Jesus, before he is crucified, talks to the disciples and tells them that I will go, but I will bring for you another comforter. If you begin from verse 1 of chapter 14, he is telling the disciples that he's praying. He is going to his father. He is going to prepare for them. And Peter, James, and John, they began to be afraid. Why? This guy is leaving us. Why is he leaving us? Eh? We have rocked the Roman Empire. Now he wants to leave. And Jesus is giving them what? An assurance. That even if I go, I will not leave you as orphans. I will give you another comforter. Praise the Lord Jesus. And when the first speaker was ministering in the morning, I said, oh boy, God, this is how wonderful you are. You have comforted this gentleman, even in the challenges. Praise the name of the Lord. Some people could be crying, weeping next to their children. They would tell Pastor, I'm not coming to church. Because Pastor, you just know, even you, we were with you yesterday. How can I leave my child? How can I leave my wife? How can I leave my house that I'm coming to minister? Praise the name of Jesus. Man of God, God bless you so much. And the Bible says that there are many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God delivers them in all of them. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I have just compared this guy with Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Praise the name of the Lord. The people whom the Spirit could come upon. The Spirit of God would come upon them and live. And they had the audacity to tell Nebuchadnezzar, oh, King Nebuchadnezzar, live forever. That is what I saw. This man of God was telling the devil, you, just even if it is that sickness, just be there. One thing you must know, that I am going to stand in the gap. Praise the name of Jesus. And healing divine help upon the young child in the name of Jesus. So, when we have the Holy Ghost with us and in us, we are well able. Praise the name of the Lord. You are doing the study of the book of Joshua, and when you come, Joshua is a man who was a servant of Moses. But when we look at the book of Numbers, Joshua was one of the spies that was sent to go and spy Jericho and came back with a report. But if you read Numbers chapter 13, the Bible says that Joshua and Caleb had another spirit, meaning there was a hand that was mantling Joshua and Caleb. Praise the name of Jesus. So, as the church today, the world, when we look at what is happening, the world has gone haywire. And it will take one who is up in the spirit to walk. I heard the man of God give testimonies of servants of God, mighty men who walked in faith, fathers who went ahead of us, living the faith and getting backward. It is not because they want. Praise the name of Jesus. It is because the world has come to a place where people want their own fame. The Bible says that in the last days, people shall be lovers of money. They will speak of themselves when Paul is telling Timothy. So when we are in this era and God has brought this topic of the Holy Ghost, then we need to get deeper into the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of Jesus. Because they are familiar spirits. I never want to talk about familiar spirit. There are so many spirits. When you were growing up in salvation, We are being told that when you meet someone, you test the spirits. Praise the name of Jesus. Test the spirits. Before you go to that church, please test the spirit. And how would we test the spirit? You would stand and begin to praise the Lord. And you hear how they praise. Praise the name of Jesus. So, in the church today, we have left some fundamental doctrines of Christ that makes the church to deviate from the way of Christ and do their own ways. Hallelujah. Amen. That is why the Holy Ghost is here to direct us, to give us the way, to walk with us, to show us what we are supposed to do. Praise the name of the Lord. Because Jesus tells the disciples in John chapter 16 that the Holy Spirit shall guide you. They are asking, how will we know? But he's saying, the Holy Spirit shall guide you into all truth and shall bring you into the remembrance of the things which are said. Praise the name of the Lord. So that is how the Holy Ghost is important to us. Very, very important to the church. The church today must walk filled by the Holy Ghost. I love God and I love the man of God. I have heard there are some churches when you go, they don't speak in tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. They don't speak in tongues. When you speak in tongues, they look at you and like, hey, what is happening really? Are they talking Greek? Hallelujah. But he says that if you have the tongues, meaning some people may not have the what? The tongues. And the first sign of the Holy Ghost in filling is speaking in other tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. You have to speak in other tongues. If you don't speak in other tongues, then it means you are not filled with the Holy Ghost. Then maybe you are filled with something else. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. So, it is a promise by Jesus to us as the church. The Holy Ghost is a comforter. He's our helper. He is the spirit of truth. He is our teacher. He is our reminder. Praise the name of the Lord. I can remember when I was born again, it was not easy. Those days it was hard. Walking in salvation was not easy. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. It's not like these days when we just, maybe you can just go to church anyhow. Those days, if you are to go to church, you first look at how you are putting on. You don't put them on. Praise the name of Jesus. If you are a woman, your head is tied, your ears, your clothes is like mine. Eh? Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. That you are not seen. Part of your body cannot be seen. That is when we were born again in 1990s. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. But now we live by faith, not by sight. Praise the name of the Lord. So it is the Holy Ghost that guides us, that teaches us, that reminds us of what we are supposed to do. Hallelujah. So, it is the spirit of truth. It cannot mislead you. It can take you even to the outermost part of the world. And Jesus says that you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses. So, any child of God who is filled by the Holy Ghost is first a witness. Praise the name of Jesus. Before you become a pastor, before you become a bishop, before you become an apostle, the Bible says you are a witness unto Jesus. What are you witnessing? Praise the name of Jesus. Mark chapter 16, verse 15. The Bible says that, and the signs of them that believe. There are things that a believer must walk with. One who is filled by the Holy Ghost, there are things that you must walk with. The Bible says that he shall speak in other tongues. A sign of the Holy Ghost. A sign of the infilling of the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So, when we are filled by the Holy Ghost, when we talk about the Holy Ghost, we talk about a person. Jesus represented in the person. That is why Paul tells the church of Corinthians, 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 14, that the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with him, the love of the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Praise the name of Jesus. The word fellowship means koinonia, partnership, to be in one. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. To be one with the Holy Ghost. That you may partner with the Holy Ghost. So as a child of God, you have to partner with the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. How do we get filled by the Holy Spirit? How do we get filled by the Holy Spirit? Number one, by desire. You are filled by desire. How much hungry are you? How much do you desire? Psalms chapter 42. Read from verse 1 to verse 3. Bible says, how the deer panted after the water brooks, so my soul panted after thee. When shall I reach to drink of you? My tears are my food day and night. Why? Because I desire more of you. Praise the name of Jesus. You can be filled by the Holy Ghost the first time, but there is a desire to walk in the depth of the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of Jesus. That one takes your desire. It takes how hungry you are. Hallelujah. It does not just come, and it will not just be put on you. You can be taught how to be filled, but if you don't desire to be filled, you can never be filled. Praise the name of Jesus. So it needs your desire. Do you desire? What is your degree? How much do you want God? Praise the name of the Lord Jesus. I want to be filled more. Daily in my life I say, God, fill me more. Because the devil, the Bible says, works day and night while the child sleeps. Praise the name of Jesus. We have gone to a slumber land while the enemy is working, making missiles every day. And we sleep. We say today it was pastor to pray. Today, you know, we made a register, a duty roster. Praise the name of the Lord. We have even made duty rosters for God. Say today, I'm not going to speak in tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. And the word of God says in Psalm chapter 100 that enter his gate with thanksgiving. How do you begin to give God thanks? Praise the name of Jesus. Some people think that when you begin to speak in tongues, before you start to pray, it is wrong. No. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Paul tells the church of Corinthians that he who speaks in tongues edifies himself. He speaks mysteries. He does not speak to men, but speaks unto God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Until the church will walk to that maturity to speak in tongues, praise the name of the Lord. One night I was in a vision, and the vision was a very dangerous one. I was in the midst, like I was taken in the midst of where the devils, they are there, they are cocoon, and I was taken there with a rope. And when I began to pray in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, there was nothing. But when I begin to speak in tongues, they began to fall down. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning, demons understand English. Demons understand your mother tongue. Demons understand Kiswahili. But they cannot understand the tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. Because he who speaks in tongues speaks unto God. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So, if you desire, you can speak in tongues even 12 hours, even 24 hours, even 72 hours, the much you want. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Because when you begin to speak in tongues, the Bible says, now unto him, Ephesians chapter 3 verses 20, who is able to do exceeding abundant above all that you think or imagine, according to the power that works in you, not the power that works in Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As you speak in tongues, you re-energize yourself. You get strength. You cannot get tired. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You can pray for even a week. Just walking along the streets through Pashalabush, speaking in tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. Some days back when I was in Awenda, I would walk along the roads, the streets, and speak in tongues, and people would look at me. I'm speaking by myself. My tongues are just moving power. So when they could meet me, there is a pastor's wife who told me, Irene, I could not even talk to you because you are very harsh, praise the name of Jesus, and always talking, and I knew you are a police woman. I could speak every time. Crap. Greetings, I mean, you may think I'm seeing you, I'm not seeing you. Why? Because I am speaking to God. Praise the name of Jesus. And I love what the man of God said when he was speaking. That in that storm, there is God. Hallelujah. That time I was speaking in tongues, I didn't even have food to eat. Praise the name of the Lord. I didn't even have clothes to wear. I had one dress. Praise the name of the Lord. And some goma rabbas. Oh, and I would speak in tongues every time. And I was speaking big things. Praise the name of Jesus. Desire. I told God, if you are lifting people from down here, then you must begin with me. And if it is this way you have to begin with me, then you have to feel me. Praise the name of Jesus. And today, if you desire to be filled again, to get into higher realms, you will be filled. Praise the name of Jesus. Proverbs 28, verse 1, the Bible says, through desire, a man separates himself and intermeddles with all wisdom. A man through desire, not by force. Praise the name of Jesus. That time when I was speaking in tongues, my mother was not with me. My father wasn't with me. Nobody was with me. I was with my children. Praise the name of Jesus. And they didn't understand what was happening. They were even asking me, Mom, why are we even going to church? Hallelujah. Why should we go to church anyway? And because this God is not seeing us. Hallelujah. So it is through desire that you will receive God today. It is through desire that you will move to another level. It is through desire that you will be filled again. Praise the name of Jesus. Even when you read the book of Ezekiel, you know, Ezekiel had to move from one step to another. After one step, he went to another step until he was filled. Praise the name of Jesus. So God will wait for you to come. He is ready to fill you. But if you don't have desire, he will not come. Praise the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Through desire, a man separates himself and intermingles with all wisdom. And wisdom is in the speaking of tongues. Number two, by faith. You receive tongues by faith. What is faith? We have defined faith as an evidence of things not seen, things that we hope for. And that is not only faith, praise the name of Jesus. Faith entails two things. You believe and you take action. Hallelujah. Because you may believe, and if you don't take action, nothing will happen. Look at Peter at the beautiful gate. When they are with John, they find a man who is lame. And this man asks them for money. And I love what Peter says, that silver and gold. Peter is with John. Church of Jesus, praise the Lord.
Amen.
They are with John, and he says, silver and gold, I have none. Why, where did he leave John? They are together. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And Peter sees this man, that this man wants to receive. And this man cannot stand up. So he holds the hands of this man to help him to stand up and begins to walk. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
So you have to work faith. The Bible says we are given a measure through faith, each one of us, a measure through faith. Meaning when we are born again, the moment you believe Christ, there is a measure of faith that you are given. So as you grow, you will move from faith to faith. That time you have only believed that people can be born again. You have believed that Jesus died. You still don't believe, maybe you are not healed. Praise the name of Jesus. So you begin to move from one step to another, from one level to another. We move from level to level, from glory to glory, from strength to strength, from power to power. Praise the name of Jesus. And that is why the servants of God are not the same. They walk in different graces. Depending on the grace operating on someone, it will be according to desire. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So we need to have the faith of God. Galatians chapter 2 verses 20. The Bible says that I am crucified by Christ. Nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ lives in me. The life that I now live, I live by the faith of the Son of God. Meaning my faith no more works. Praise the name of Jesus. In the church today, we are still walking at a place where our faith is the one that leads us. Praise the name of Jesus. Amen. We need to come to a place where we let the faith of God. And that is the place of surrender. Hallelujah. So you can receive the Holy Ghost by surrender. You surrender to Him. You don't surrender your body. You may surrender your body, lie on the floor with your body, but when your heart is not broken, Psalms 51, verse 17. David cried. David says that a broken and a contrite spirit, a broken heart and a contrite spirit, God cannot forsake. Praise the name of the Lord. So when you are broken before God, you go before God broken, surrendering to Him. Sometimes God speaks to us that you need to move from this place to another, but we are standing like statues. We are there. Praise the name of Jesus. God wants you to change your level of worship, your level of study of the Word of God. But what do? You stay there, you remain. Say, there is brother so-and-so who can teach. There is sister so-and-so who can worship God. But the Holy Ghost wants to lift you to another level. The Holy Ghost wants to take you to a deeper realm. The Holy Ghost wants to speak through you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Do you know that we can all give words of prophecy? We can, because the prophecy is the testimony of Christ. The prophetic word is the testimony of Christ. And Paul says, you prophesy according to the proportion of your what? Of your faith. Praise the name of Jesus. So when we go deep, we can have prophetic worship. I'm looking for a time that the church will just worship God in tongues. We just begin to worship God in tongues. As we play the keys, we worship God in tongues. We would see the 24 elders coming down to worship God with us. Praise the name of Jesus. God is waiting for a worship. Pastor Jonga, not a worship that comes from our mind. True worshipers that will worship God in spirit and in truth. And it cannot be in truth if there is no spirit. That is why God, the word of God says that it is in spirit and in truth. Praise the name of Jesus. That we just begin to worship God. Just wait to want to hear the new word that God is giving us in His worship. Then the words comes. Praise the name of Jesus. I'm looking for a time that the church will walk in that maturity that we will just worship God. That when I meet a man of God, we just speak in tongues. And he speaks back in me, to me in tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. Because the word of God says that we have the ability, we have the capability, we have all that it takes. We have the word of God. The Bible says that the word of God is with us. It is not far. It is just in our mouth. You speak it and you receive it. Praise the name of Jesus. Because Proverbs chapter 23 verse 7 says, but be that as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. So when you think a mediocre in the line of the spirit, you remain a mediocre. Praise the name of Jesus. I refuse to walk in mediocrity. No. Say, God, if you have given me this gift, then hey, cause me to use this gift to explore my generation. Praise the name of Jesus. And what about the generation coming after us? If we don't speak the word of God in truth, what about the generation that will come? If we don't teach about the Holy Ghost, praise the name of the Lord. Because right now, as we speak, so many things are happening. When Corona hit, God spoke to me. I took some time. I told God, I want to know where this is from. And the whole period when we were not in school, I was in the presence of God every day, telling God, I want some. I go dry, I go half, I go 14, 21, depending on how God has led me. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And I wanted to know. And God opened my eyes to see. Some of those things, if I say, no man will believe. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. That's why sometimes it is good to be reserved, to keep quiet. Wait. Paul tells doctors that study to be quiet. Praise the name of Jesus. So a time reaches when you study to be quiet, because the time for speaking will come. Praise the name of Jesus. At the moment the president lifted out the curfew, I don't know what you saw, what I saw, the schools began to light fire. Praise the name of Jesus. So the devil began to work in a different way. It can only take someone in the spirit to know that it has shifted from Corona, it has come back, because still it is touching economy. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. This school is on fire. This one is on fire. Immediately the president lifted the curfew. Kipsigis girls began. Kericho boys. Everything. Now it is in every county. Schools. And there's no reason why they are banning it. The devil is annoyed. Praise the name of Jesus. He wanted to erase the whole race. But God found some people who were in the spirit and stood in the gap. And that is why we need to give God our hearts. Lord, I give you my soul. Give you my heart. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm away. Lord, have your way. Hallelujah. When will we give God our hearts? When will we surrender for the Holy Spirit? This generation, the Bible says in Joel chapter 2, verses 28, that in the last days I shall pour my spirit upon all flesh. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning the spirit of God is outpoured. It requires those who are desiring, those who are walking by faith, those who have surrendered. Praise the name of Jesus. But now, what is happening to us? Aye. Haka sisi tunajua. Kaya hii tumekua tukiiva sana. Even if you're being told, my brother, it is not this way. Come, let's do it this way. Praise the name of Jesus. And allow the Berean church. Afterwards, they will go scrutinize the man of God and say, the man of God say this and that. Let's go back. Praise the name of Jesus. It takes a man of the spirit or a woman of the spirit to go back and study the word of God. Praise the name of Jesus. We just want to come to church. have a good voice. My voice is maybe soprano or alto or bass. See, mine is not even in the gift God. Praise the name of Jesus. But I tell God, this voice must worship you. Whether it likes it or not. Praise the name of Jesus. Because God gives ability. Hallelujah. It is time we come out of things that we know. I am the one who must do this. Before I leave that worship, you know. That worship cannot work. Praise the name of Jesus. Before I leave the service, you know, someone, praise the name of Jesus. God wants us to worship Him in spirit and in truth. And when you refuse that voice, God will raise thorns. The Bible says that if my people refuse, I will raise thorns. Praise the name of Jesus. Put my spirit in them. And the word of God says, all flesh. They will preach Jesus. Is it not in the Bible where the donkey talked? Hallelujah. Animals talked in the Bible. The Bible says that in the last days I shall pour my spirit upon all flesh. And your daughters shall prophesy. The old men shall dream dreams. When I speak, are we prophesying now? Are our daughters prophesying? Are the old men dreaming? Because we are not walking in the Holy Ghost. We are walking by our minds. We go to the internet and begin looking for the next someone. Oh, this one did not bonk a preach in 10 years ago. Okay, let me look at it. Okay, this one has been preached by Chris Oyakilom. Let me try. I'll calculate it a bit. We have denied the Holy Spirit to work. Praise the name of Jesus. Theology is not bad. It is good because it gives us the way. But there is the leading of the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You can have the gift of writing songs, but without the Holy Ghost, there is nothing you can do. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So this afternoon, I don't know if it's already afternoon. This afternoon, we want to surrender to God, to sink deep in the Holy Ghost. We need to sink deep. The desire of my heart is that I live a life in my generation, that even if the life that I live, I die, then revival begins. Praise the name of Jesus. Let revival begin, and let it be that there was someone who took upon this mantle. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So we need to surrender to the Holy Ghost. And another thing, number four, is by understanding. By understanding. If you don't understand, you can do nothing. Psalms 119, verse 89, the Bible says, your testimonies, verse 144, your testimonies are everlasting. Give me understanding and I shall live. Praise the name of Jesus. Meaning without understanding, there is no life. And the Holy Ghost is the giver of understanding. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost is the giver of understanding. So we have to receive the understanding. Paul prayed to the church of Ephesians and he prayed to the church of Colossians. He said that I pray, Ephesians chapter 1, we read from verse 17, that day and night I think about you in my prayers, that God, the God of all glory, may give unto you the understanding that you may know His will in your life. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. And it takes the Holy Spirit for you to know the will of God and to receive and to walk in the perfect and the acceptable will of God. Praise the name of Jesus. So we need to wait. We need to tarry. When Jesus told the disciples that you tarry, wait, wait, tarry in Jerusalem. Tarry in Jerusalem until you are endued with power. Tarry in Jerusalem until you are endued with power. People, nowadays we don't wait. Praise the name of Jesus. For us preachers, we don't wait. ukisikia umesifiwa kidogo, at least umehubiri mahali, umeona miujiza moja, hivyo sasa wewe ni mkubwa, unaanza kutembea na vitu kubwa. Hey, now I'm a big man. I am a big woman right now. I can't wait. Ah, when will I meet so and so? Get in this podium and preach. I'll preach Jesus. And you begin to rectify ministers on the pulpit. Praise the name of Jesus. As they preach, say, ah, ile grammar hii kwenda vizuri. Pale naye Kiswahili chake kilikuwa mbovu kidogo. Ah, you know that scripture says this. This is what should have been spoken. Praise the name of Jesus. You know, the word of God is revealed to each and every person the way it is. Hallelujah. Because how much do I want to know God? How much do you want to know God? So the revelation of God's word comes to me how much I want to know God. Praise the name of Jesus. And if they are worshippers, they are given podium to worship and they begin to, you know, we give you glory. You either have to be vizuri. Let me bring it in another version, okay? And we give you all that glory. We worship you, Lord. You are to pray. Praise the Lord Jesus. Because you are trying to subtract what God has given to someone because you lack understanding. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Because when you worship God, and the worship of God is in His word. And when someone begins to worship, God gives you the revelation of how to do it. Praise the name of Jesus. So if we do not walk in understanding, then we will go astray. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So we must walk in understanding. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to look at one thing, then we pray. One thing, then we pray. How can we get filled with the Holy Ghost? How? No. How do you know that you are filled? Praise the name of Jesus. How many are filled by the Holy Ghost, speaking in tongues? Filled by the Holy Ghost and speaking in tongues. Because if you don't have the tongues, today you are going to receive the tongues. You cannot talk about Holy Ghost and fail to manifest the Holy Ghost. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So, for you to know that you are filled by the Holy Ghost, number one is tongues. The only thing very outstanding. Number one, tongues. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2. Chapter 2, you read from verses 1 to 4. The Bible says, and when the day of the Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly, there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting, and there appeared unto them the cloven tongues like as of fire, and sat upon each of them. Verse 4. And they were filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Praise the name of Jesus. So it is the utterance given by the Holy Ghost Himself. That is why He comes to certify that you are filled. So the certification of infilling of the Holy Ghost is tongues. Praise the name of Jesus. That is the key thing. Tongues. One of my pastors one day used to say that you begin speaking in tongues like rabba rabba. The next day you say rabba rabba pencil. The third day you say rabba rabba pencil big. The fourth day you say rabba rabba pencil big book. Praise the name of Jesus. So that means you are moving from level 2. You are not in bed, you are not stagnant. You know, even if you give birth to a child who is stagnant, who is a dwarf, you know, you say, ah,
Na huyu mtoto wangu akui, ni nini mbaya? Kumpeleka kwa madaktari, waangalie ni nini mbaya? Hata wewe uta chai, Jesus himself does not want us to remain dwarfs in the spirit. So you have to grow. You grow from one level to another. Praise the name of Jesus. We grow to a level until when I speak in tongues, the man of God is able to understand, to know, to interpret. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That is also different from the gift of tongues. There are people who have the gifts of tongues, that they can speak in so many tongues. And those ones, they speak to the church. They edify the body of Christ. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So, number one thing is that you must speak in tongues. Number two, you must be a witness. You must be a witness. You must be a witness. Jesus meets Paul. He did not even see Paul, and Paul did not even see Jesus at the time of their meeting. He met Jesus, and Jesus said that you will be a witness unto the things that have appeared unto you and the things which I will show you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It means we become witnesses of what we have experienced and witnesses of what we will experience. Meaning, our experience cannot remain where we are. Our experience moves from level to level. So if I'm a witness today that God is a healer, that God is a restorer, that God is a builder, then tomorrow I must be a witness that God can do something else. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Because our God, the Bible says, is infinite. He is not finite. He is infinite. He works in different many ways. He does so many things at different times. Hallelujah. And a witness here is a validator of a claim. Someone who proves the existence of something. For example, I know God is a comforter. Praise the name of Jesus. I know God is a comforter because he has comforted me. I'm a witness. I have experienced his comfort. I have walked in that comfort. I know God is a provider. And I know the Holy Ghost directs. He shows you what to do. Praise the name of Jesus. When Jesus says that he will guide you and put you in remembrance of all things, I know he will. And I know he does. Because I have experienced that. Praise the name of Jesus. And I will still continue to experience. Praise the name of Jesus. So, after receiving the Holy Ghost, don't just sit. Sometimes you're feeling like you want to worship God. Don't just sit. And don't limit God. He cannot only fill you in church. The Holy Ghost can fill you even when you are digging at home. Praise the name of Jesus. Even when you are cooking. I can remember when I was first filled with the Holy Ghost. It was in 1993. There was a man of God called Joshua Bong. He was teaching on the cross, and it was a whole fellowship in Voice of Salvation at home. And some things were happening to girls who were around me. I had just done my class 8 at that time, and I asked them, "Sir, tell me, why is it that so and so, this and this happened?" And he told me, "You know, it is only one thing that can help you get born again." And I got born again. So when I was hearing people saying, speaking in tongues, I'm like, do I begin imitating what these people? If I begin to imitate in ninachoka, nani inapotea, so, how do I go about it? So one day, I was walking around our home, and I used to go to a certain thick bush, and I could preach there, put stones and begin to preach Jesus. Preach and say, these are the lame that are walking, the dead are raised. I could go that extreme. Praise the name of Jesus. So one day I went there. And after going there, I began to do. No, kitamba kukuwa na hizi chores and tukonazo sahi. I could cheat my mom. Mami, nataka kuenda haja, siendi haja. Naenda kuhubiria wale watu wangu. Niliwaacha kwa kichaka. So I began to preach. Jesus kills. Jesus saves. Jesus heals. He can do it today. today. He's the same yesterday and today. Jack would say what the late Silas already would say. And that is what I could use. One that day, as I was saying those things, I heard a sound. And all of a sudden, a lion appeared. I tried to run and I could not run. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Because a lion. And when the lion saw that I was afraid, he began to smile. And I'm like, today I'm mad. I'm not alive. Today I'm dead. Praise the name of Jesus. So this lion waved the hands and began to tell me, I have come to talk to you. In our Kijaluo, I said, me? What have I done? Then, because I was not mature to contain, he disappeared. Praise the name of Jesus. And when I turned to go home, I began to speak in tongues. And I spoke in tongues. I spoke in tongues. My mom came to look for me. They were like, are you mad? I spoke in tongues from that time, from 10 in the morning to 4 in the evening. I walked home on my knees, praise the name of Jesus. And my life has never remained the same. What I asked was to me. So when you speak in tongues, you become a witness. And from that day till today, I'm still a witness. What I asked was to me. So the Spirit of God is a promise. When you have the Spirit of God in the inside of you, you will prophesy. You will see visions. You will dream dreams. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Hallelujah. There are miracles, signs, and wonders that will follow you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Personally, I've experienced miracles. I've experienced wonders. Hallelujah. Sometimes I ask God, why do you let me go through this? He let me, when he wants to see, when he sees that I'm so inquisitive, he puts me down. Inakuwa kama niko mgonjwa kidogo, sitaki kutembea. At least then I sleep. Wants me to rest. And when I go to rest, he begins to speak. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. So the Holy Spirit is able to give you direction. The Holy Spirit is able to teach you. So when you have the Holy Spirit in you, you can tread upon serpents and upon scorpions. You can walk in any place. And that is why Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had the audacity to tell Nebuchadnezzar that all Nebuchadnezzar live forever. Praise the name of Jesus. And even right now, you cannot pray for that disease to go. Tell it to stay. Because there is God. Even if God will not deliver you from that one, but know that I will not bow to you. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. It is one thing for the devil, for the disease to remain in the inside of you and cannot affect you. That one is more troublesome. Praise the name of Jesus. The disease is inside. The germ is there. If it is bacteria or virus, but it cannot kill you because you know that your blood, the blood of Jesus, is streaming in your bloodstream. Praise the name of Jesus. That is the most frustrating thing. Even in an institution, someone needs promotion and cannot be promoted. That person is frustrated. You know, if the devil also works in rams. So, if you have the Holy Spirit in you, you will walk in signs, miracles, and wonders. Hallelujah. And as a child of God, we need to walk in signs and wonders. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is a quickener. It quickens. When you have the Holy Ghost, you are quickened. Even when things are slow, your speed is quickened. The Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 18, verses 46, that and the Spirit of God, the hand of God, was upon Elijah. And he went and overtook the chariots of Ahab into Jezreel. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Today, if you receive the infilling of the Holy Ghost, you will be quickened into your destiny in the name of Jesus Christ. And the Holy Ghost is a revealer of mysteries. He will reveal to you mysteries. He will reveal mysteries. The things that are hidden. Which Paul says that the things that the eyes of men have not seen. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 9. The things that the eyes of men have not seen, you see by the Spirit. The things that the ears of men have not heard, you will hear by the Spirit. The things that men have not perceived by the hearts, you will perceive by the Spirit. They are only sought by the Spirit of God. So this afternoon, I want us to pray that we may get a new infilling of the Holy Ghost. That the filling of the Holy Ghost may dwell in us. That it may work in us. That we may walk in it. The Old Testament could not be filled by the Holy Ghost. And Jesus says that we cannot put a new wine upon an old wineskin. And that is why he brought a new wineskin for us, that we may be filled with a new wine. So this afternoon, as we want to pray that God may fill us once again by the Holy Spirit. That God may take us to a deeper level in the Spirit. I want us to pray that the Lord God of Israel may refill us once again, that we may walk in the spirit of wisdom, that we may walk in the spirit of understanding, that we may walk in the spirit of knowledge, that as God is infilling us this afternoon, we have crossed the Jordan, and our crossing is by infilling. Stand up on your feet.